Hey guys, it is Julie here with TipRanks. In today's video, we're taking a look at three trending growth stocks. We're going to look at what each of these companies do, plus what analysts are predicting for their stock's future. Just before we get into that, this is just your friendly reminder that if you enjoy today's video, make sure you hit that thumbs up button and that you're subscribed to the channel as well. I'm here Monday through Friday with pre-market morning update videos, bringing you up to speed on everything you need to know before the opening bell, so make sure to check those out. Now, when I say trending stocks, I came across these using one of TipRank's many research tools. And right under the research tools and top stocks section, you can see the trending stocks. Now, when I say trending stocks, I'm referring to stocks that have recently gotten new or reiterated ratings from analysts. On the left, we have several filtering options as far as best rated, worst rated, or most rated, the period of time, whether that's 72 hours, 7 days, or 30 days, we can rate by market cap as well as sector. So today I decided I wanted to look at both large and medium market cap companies, and there were three that jumped out from their upside potential along with being a strong buy. Now, I will point out that Ring Central under RNG did have the highest potential upside, but I did just recently do a video on them a couple weeks ago, so I wanted to focus on three fresh picks for you guys today. So, taking a closer look at those three companies, starting out with Canadian Natural. They trade under the ticker CNQ and are currently priced at $30.52 per share. Now, you guys know I love a good dividend, and Canadian Natural does pay one. It is a quarterly dividend of 37 cents per share for a dividend yield of 4.77%, with the next ex-dividend date today on March 18th. Among the best performing investors on the TipRanks Smart Portfolio, we've seen an increase of nearly 20% in CNQ holdings over the last 30 days. Canadian Natural is one of the largest independent natural gas producers in Canada. They're also the largest heavy crude oil producer in Canada, with a portfolio that consists of light crude oil, primary heavy crude oil, Pelican Lake crude oil, and natural gas liquids. This diversified portfolio of assets is in North America, the UK North Sea, and offshore Africa. In oil sands mining and upgrading, they have world-class oil sands mining opportunity, with 6.9 billion barrels of company gross proved, plus probable SCO reserves. In international crude oil, they have development and exploration opportunities in offshore Africa and development opportunities in the UK region of the North Sea. Canadian Natural did have an earnings report just a couple of weeks ago, and they came out with quarterly earnings of 12 cents per share, beating the consensus estimate of just 4 cents per share. This quarterly report represents an earnings surprise of 200%. A quarter ago, it was expected that this oil and natural gas company would post earnings of 2 cents per share when it actually produced earnings of 8 cents per share for another surprise of 300%. Their total revenues of $3.85 billion surpassed the estimate of $3.83 billion, however, did decline from their previous year. During the quarter under review, the company, which is committed to adding shareholder value, returned over $500 million via dividends. Following this earnings report, we saw many analysts reiterate their price targets, landing the CNQ stock on the trending list. We currently have 14 analyst ratings on the stock. And it does come in as a strong buy, based on 13 buys and one hold. The average price target is $37.44 for about a 22% potential upside. Looking at our detailed list of forecasts there, our lowest price target is $33.90 for about a 10.9% potential upside. On the high end, we do have one $43.59 price target, which would be over a 42% potential growth. The second company on our trending stock list is JD.com. Trading under the ticker JD, they're currently priced at $84.98 per share. JD.com is China's largest online retailer and its biggest overall retailer, as well as the country's biggest internet company by revenue. Their vast product offering covers everything from fresh food and apparel to electronics and cosmetics. Its unrivaled nationwide fulfillment network covers 99% of China's population. They have over 471 million annual active customers, 900 plus warehouses, and their 2020 net revenue was over 114 billion US dollars. As we said, they are China's largest online retailer, and they've seen a compound annual growth rate of 31% from 2016 to 2019, and they don't have nearly as many large competitors as their American competitor Amazon.com has when you look at the comparison list. JD.com also had an earnings report come out just this last week. They reported revenues of about $34.4 billion, surpassing the estimate of $33.1 billion and increasing over 31% year over year. The increase was driven by strong revenues from both product as well as services. In the fourth quarter, their net products revenue increased 53% from the prior year. And again, this earnings report prompted many analysts to update their price targets on the stock. So we have 16 current analyst ratings on JD.com. Coming in as a strong buy, based on 15 buy ratings and one hold, the average price target is $112.47 for a nice 32% potential upside. And you can see they pretty much all came in 6 days ago. Our lowest price target is the hold rating from KeyBank with a 17% potential upside. The highest rating comes from Benchmark Company with a $122 price tag for about a 43% potential upside. And the third trending stock that we're looking at is Twilio. Trading under the ticker TWLO, they're currently priced at $367.01. They score an 8 out of 10 on the top smart score from very bullish news sentiment, bullish blogger opinions, and positive technicals. Twilio is the world's leading cloud communication platform that enables you to engage with customers across channels such as SMS, voice, video, WhatsApp, email, and more. They're used by big companies like Lyft, Airbnb, and Netflix. They personalize every step of the customer journey with solutions like intelligent chatbots, custom account notifications, and completely programmable cloud-based call centers. This is done with marketing and lead alerts, customer service for account security, and operations for different dispatch notifications and appointment reminders. Their products include their programmable SMS, Twilio Flex, programmable voice, and Twilio SendGrid. And you may have guessed it, within the last 30 days, they also had an earnings report. They saw their fourth quarter total revenue of $548 million be up 65% year over year. Their full year of 2020 total revenue was $1.76 billion, up 55% year over year. For their 2021 guidance, they see total revenue between $526 to $536 million, which would be up 44 to 47% year over year, and their non-GAAP loss per share between 12 cents to 9 cents. On the Twilio stock, we have 23 analysts with current ratings, and it comes in as a strong buy based on 21 buy ratings and 2 holds. The average price target is about $508 for a 38% potential upside. Our lowest rating, of course, is the hold rating from Stevens with a $425 price target, which would still be a 15% potential upside. The highest price target, and there's a couple on there, come in at $550. This is from both Oppenheimer, Piper Sandler, and KeyBank. That would be nearly a 50% potential upside. So there we have three stocks trending lately based on a lot of updated price targets from analysts, and all three coming in as a strong buy with some pretty healthy potential upside there. Now, I always love hearing from you guys, so make sure to leave your thoughts on these three stocks in the comments down below. Plus, what is your favorite way to utilize the trending stock screener there? How do you come across companies in there, and what specifically do you look for? Make sure to let me know. If you enjoyed today's video, make sure you hit that thumbs up button and that you're subscribed to the channel. Don't forget to check out my pre-market update videos here Monday through Friday before the opening bell. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we will see you back here next time.